And now we want to get back to that breaking news that we are following for you this morning as firefighters are working to put out an apartment fire on Detroit's west side.
Yes, and this is as firefighters, police, and a whole army of volunteers for Angel tonight have been out trying to make sure something like this doesn't happen. But investigators do say it's arson. Let's get to Nick Monticelli. He's been out live on the scene for the last few hours, and firefighters made a lot of progress here, Nick.
They did. This was a massive billowing fire all morning long, Rhonda, but as you can see behind me, there are some areas of this apartment that have restarted on fire, not necessarily because it was intentional, but simply because you've got lots of hot embers and embers that can rekindle and break this happen again. So you can see in the first floor of this apartment, there is a lot of fire in there right now, and certainly there is some concern all of this is going to spread again, even though most of this apartment has already been charred by fire, not just this time, but also by another arson that happened back in February. Now, we can show you some video that was taken at about 4 o'clock this morning when all of this began. Actually, the first call for this was about 3:30. So about 3 hours ago, all of this began. And this, as you mentioned, is arson. We're some investigators that knows what was going on here. Now, this fire again, intentionally set in the first floor of this building and then spreading up and lighting almost every floor on fire on top of that. Most of the fire was in the fourth floor, that roof burning, it collapsed. Aerial trucks were able to get some water in there and get most of the flames out. But as I mentioned, there are now flames again in the first floor or the basements of this fire. But it did not take long at all for investigators to know this was arson because their investigators out patrolling on Angel's Night found it.
The fire was discovered by two arson investigators that were out on patrol. When they first saw the fire, that was in the basement, and there were multiple spots where the fire was burning, so they're going to call it an arson fire.
All right, now, as I mentioned, this is Angel's Night. This is Angel's Weekend, where there are hundreds, thousands of volunteers that try to patrol this city, preventing something like this from happening. So if you want to help with that, you can do so. Tonight is the last night of the Angel's Night patrols. Those patrols begin at 6 p.m. And again, these volunteers are patrolling these neighborhoods, trying to deter arson. All these volunteers are spread out throughout the entire city of Detroit. If you want to volunteer in one of your local precincts, you can do that. You can sign up by calling 313-224-4415. That's your best way to sign up. Again, now looking live at this fire and what firefighters are trying to do. They have now pulled more hoses back out. They're trying to battle this fire again that is now rekindled on the bottom floor, the first floor, or the basements of this apartment. Most of the crews had been released because most of this fire was out, so there are a few firefighters here left. There are two aerial trucks, a pumper here off to our side, but they've got plenty of manpower to work on this and make sure this doesn't keep rekindling overnight. They will be out here for several more hours to make sure every flame, every ember is gone. We're live here at Detroit's West Side. Nick Monticelli, Local 4 News today.
And Nick, of course, we know this entire weekend is one that's always very busy for our firefighters, although fires have been down over the years because of the Angel's Night patrols. Is this putting a strain on crews since they're going to have to be out there for hours?
You know, it is not, and specifically because it is Angel's Night, they bring in extra crews, extra engines, extra firefighters, just so something like this, if something like this does happen, it doesn't put a strain on the system. So there were crews here working that were here specifically for Angel's Night, and the deputy commissioner told me that the engines that normally will be pulled from the houses closest, they were still there working to try to help other people who might need it.
All righty. Nick Monticelli reporting live for us this morning. Thank you for the update there.